Hello guys, today I'm gonna show you how to turn this dumb alarm to a smart one with the Chipsee all-in-one Raspberry Pi computer. Well, saying this alarm is dumb is kind of unfair because it does have a remote control. If you click this button, it will, you see, hear that beep, it will set the alarm. And when you wave pass or it detects something, it will send the alarm to you, and you know somebody is coming near this alarm. And if you click this unlock button, it will disalarm, right? So how do we do this? Well, with this remote controller, we can use a radio frequency encoder and decoder. This is a small chip. I'm not sure if it's correctly focused. Okay, let me zoom in a little bit. This is a radio frequency encoder and decoder. It has a 315 megahertz and a 433 megahertz signal. It can encode and decode both these signal. And this dumb remote has is 433. So today I'm gonna connect this one to the our Raspberry Pi computer. This all-in-one Chipsee Raspberry Pi computer comes with a this black folded pin Raspberry Pi adapter. It will extend the GPIO and another. Oh my god, this is not very very well focused, but you know the idea. It has 40 pin, and you can use the serial port of the all-in-one Raspberry Pi computer to send a signal from this chip with Python, and we will be able to copy the signal from this remote and replicate them from this chip and control this dumb alarm from our Raspberry Pi, and we can then run a cron tab, cron job to set a periodic, or it can set alarm every morning or every night, and we will leave home or come back home, disalarm, those kind of things. Okay, let's see how to program this thing. Okay, first we will need to connect these two together. This module has a 4-pin connector. That's you can see that. Well, it's here. This is VCC, and this is GND, the leftmost and the rightmost one. And it has a TX and RX. These are the serial ports. You may need to connect the TX to the RX of our Raspberry Pi adapter board, and you may need to connect RX to the TX of our Raspberry Pi connector board. And also, of course, the VCC and the GND has to be connected to VCC and GND to power this module up. And on this side, you can see the text is relatively small, but here. You could use these two 5 volts as VCC, and then there is a GND. I connected the VCC to the 5 volts, and GND, this purple wire to GND, and you can see this green wire, this green debunk wire, I connected to the UART TX. On this one is this green one is here. The second from the right is the this is the RX, and here we connect it to TX, the green one TX, and the last one, this brown one is RX here, and this RX is connected to this to the TX. You can see it here. The second on the left, the brown one, is the TXD. So TX to RX, RX to TX, and connect the power of VCC and GND to 5 volts and GND. Well, this is so small, it's hard to focus. Okay, let me show you a program I built before, and then I will show you how to build this program. This program listens from the serial port. It listens from TT1S0. S0 is the serial port of this Chipsee Raspberry Pi computer. And the baud rate is 9600. And this module accepts 8 bit every time a signal comes. So I'm gonna hard code this the 8 bytes. I'm sorry. I'm gonna hard code this 8 here. And when I click enter, this program it will keep listening for incoming signals until it's see something, it will print the signal to the screen. Okay, now it's listening for radio frequency signals. I'm gonna use this remote to send some signals for the program to copy. You see, when I click this button, this remote is actually a very cheap one. It sends like 6 to 10 signals. Repeat 6 to 10 times only for this dumb alarm to be able to accept the signal reliably. So you could see on the computer on screen here this signal is like FD, F4. Okay, let me rotate a little bit, and I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. So this is the signal this this dumb remote sends. It's FD and F4. These 2 bytes, according to the menu of this, according to the menu of this module, is fixed. It starts with FD and ends with DF. And this F4, when you use a 433 megahertz signal, it shows a F4 here because it's dual signal, right? It's dual signal. If you receive a 315 megahertz signal, this will be F3, and this O3 is maybe it's fixed. I don't remember what it is. And these three bytes, the 01, 0D, C8, are the actual signal of this remote. And this 34 is according to the datasheet or the menu of this module is a some random number of fixed one. Well, but we don't need to care about that. We only need to know that this module is receiving this signal. And if we replay this signal, it will be able to copy the remote. The signal is sent from this module from our Raspberry Pi computer. Okay, and I have written a helper method here. If you want to replay this signal, you can copy this line. Of course, this line is already coded in the program, and we can Control C to stop, and then Control V to replicate. Let me clear this for you. We can replay this signal from our module and in my Raspberry Pi computer, and then you can hear. Do you hear that? Sometimes this dumb alarm doesn't receive the signal. I don't know why. It's kind of a cheap one. Let me try again. Maybe it's too close to the module. Well. Well, maybe the strength of the signal has something to do with it. Oh, yeah, here it is. Okay. This dumb alarm sometimes is not working very correctly. Okay, so this is how the program is gonna be like, and let's see how to build it.